Welcome back. We're in the garage and I got something super cool today. My wife bought me something I wanted for a while and we're going to set it up here in the corner right now. For Christmas, she got me a welding table and I am super stoked to get it set up, but we got to do some cleanup because it's going to go in this area right here. So all this stuff's got to move because we're going to start doing work on building a new console. And we may be doing some welding, I don't know, but either way, I need to teach myself how to weld, and that table's gonna go right here. In my typical this is my life fashion, when this was shipped, this box got totally shredded and apparently a bunch of the hardware nuts and bolts were falling out of it. So I don't know how much is missing. We're gonna find out. Level this one that's on the ground. Yeah, those are some pretty sweet. And yes, that's the way it's supposed to be. You can see the numbers are right side up. Okay. So now the next thing is I gotta get a welding cart so I can get my welder over here in this area, and then we can work from this spot. Now one of the things that I plan to do is redo all the exhaust system on the Chevelle. And for that, I'm gonna need this table. So that'll be coming probably late next year, to be honest with you, but all right. Step in the right direction. Now we can get started on the real work.
It's been some time since I started on the console project. Hasn't been a lot of forward movement on, you know, filming or actually building anything. A lot of it has been in thinking about it and designing it, drawing it, building it out of cardboard. And I started doing a lot of 3D rendering because I was trying to mimic the factory console design, but unfortunately my 3D printer is not big enough to really print it out. I might revisit that design a little bit and see if I can somehow shrink it down, the parts of it that are important, try and maybe shrink it down a little bit that will fit on my printer. But as of right now, I'm going to have to scrap that part of it, and that took a lot of time. So forgive me, this is going to be a slow process, as I said at the beginning. So,
okay, so we're back to work on trying to design this center console. This is just a roughed-in height wise. Probably going to go a little bit lower in the middle. This is kind of what I had before, but we got to get this worked in and figure this out. I've been hanging onto this big cardboard box from when I got my gas tank. This was a few months ago. So I can use this cardboard to pattern up what I'm doing. I've already cut some, but we're about to cut out more and see if we can lay the top part on and see if we can get our contour right, because I have some specific things I want to go in this console, and it's got to be just right to hold enough space for all the items. Trimmed myself up a piece of cardboard that will be used as the centerpiece. Let's get this over here. Presto. Almost done. Okay, this is something. I'm not exactly sure if that's what I'm looking for or not. I do like the fact that this is out a bit more than it was before. So the gauges, I think, would go across the top and some stereo equipment down here. I think I need to get that piece in there and see where I'm at next. Okay, so we're just prototyping here just to see about getting the angles, and this is definitely going to be most likely too wide, but I don't have the other seat in here. I'd have to put the other seat in here, but I'm just trying to get the swooping angle of what we're looking at, and also to see if this height is going to be correct. So we're going to sit in the driver's seat and see what that looks like. Okay, so we're going to be a little bit more to the side here. It's really not that bad. It's pretty big. We're going to have to slice it and narrow it. Still thinking about moving the shifter over a little bit, maybe even back a little. But the height seems pretty good for this armrest, similar to that armrest. But it's coming along. That would have to be centered. Prototyping. Getting some clearance for the shifter. I'm not sure. Gonna have to ponder that. I mean, square box, you know, that doesn't look too good. But once I get all the accoutrements on there and start actually fabricating this, I got some ideas that are gonna bring this thing to life. Well, it's another day here in the garage, and last night after working on this thing, I came out to the garage a couple times, had a couple beers, pondered this thing, because I don't want it to look like just a square block in the car. Let me show you what I'm talking about. One of the things I did not like about the last console is that it just looked like a square block in the car. It did not fit the interior. It did not look like it belonged in the car. It wasn't horrible. It was functional. But it just didn't look like it belonged in the car. And I think my goal here is to get this thing to look like it may have come in the car. You know, add some design cues from the dashboard. Add some curves to it. The original console was kind of curvy. It had a lot of design cues, and I'm just wondering if I can bring some of that into this. The first thing I want to do is show you some of the elements that I got going on here. So you can see I've got my gauge cluster. This is not going to be the final thing. This is a test print I did just to see if I could get the gauges kind of like they were. The gauges in the old console angled toward the driver. I don't know if I'm going to do that or not. It might be just too much of a hassle, and it might, you know, the gauges in the car do not do that. I think what I'm going to try and do is mimic the bezel that goes around the gauges, which basically just stick out straight, and I may try and incorporate that. Very, very similar design and size and dimension. They're kind of petite, thin bezel. They stick out maybe a quarter inch with a slight, you know, angle to them, and I might mimic that in this design.
Below that is a piece of stereo equipment I'm going to show you later, and below that is a 20 band equalizer that I plan to incorporate into this system. Now, the width at the top isn't bad, but I want this to narrow down as it goes down towards the shifter, remain narrow, and then it'll be narrow here. You can see we have no clearance for the seat belt right now. So this is gonna have to narrow, and this is just too chunky. And we're gonna have to round these corners, I believe, and maybe put a design cue. I might try and incorporate that, and I might try and do some of the lines with that channel down the middle. I'm really thinking about that. See if we can 3D print it. I can really 3D print this entire piece right here on my 3D printer. So the pieces with the stereo and the gauges, that whole faceplate could be one. And I would like to try and mimic this lined design right here. I don't know if I can, but I think I might try it. We're also going to put AC vents back here, possibly using the vents that I did not use in my AC kit. Those are right here. So I got two of these, and these might be kind of cool back here. You know, put those right here, which might be kind of cool, and then they can be angled in whatever direction they need to go. And of course, we're going to have the light. We're going to have a light back down here, and that light is actually in the old console, which is over here. This is a factory light. So that's nice. It's got chrome on it. It's a little worn, but that light does work. And it worked in the console before, so I would like to put that back into the console. So have some vents back there. Do some ducting through the console. Over here on the sides, I want to put up some pockets, either a net or a physical pocket you put your phone in. And on the inside of this, there's gonna be a charging pad for wireless charging. So you just pop your phone in and then wireless charging, no wires hanging around and all that BS. Yeah, so I think to start with this morning, we're gonna try narrowing this a bit. And in my old console, I had cup holders. This will not have cup holders. I'm going to show you a trick later on where I plan to put the cup holders in this car, but that's going to be down the line. So let's go ahead and trim this in, narrow this, and see what that looks like. So now we can see how narrow things need to be to clear the seats with both the seats in there. So we're going to have to narrow it. I think we're going to start narrowing right here, so if the seat ever has to go up, so we'll probably narrow it in here on both sides. Let's mark that up and then we'll cut it. Got it marked up. Let's go ahead and pull the seat, pull the cardboard console, and get that adjusted. Things are definitely moving along now. I've now narrowed the center. You can see where it tapers, and I've trimmed the sides a little in the front, so it's narrower a little bit in the front. And yeah, that's definitely coming along. Give it a little more natural contour. You know, I'm going to be putting in a lot of details when I actually start building this, so it might look a little blocky still. Let's get the other seat in there and see what it looks like. There we go. So now you can see the taper is a little bit better. You got some space. Let's come over here a little bit. Got some space there for the seat belts to pop through. Let's go over on the driver's side and take a look. Pretty cool. Now, if we could also put a little pocket right here, put a cell phone. So a cell phone drop into a little pocket that'll charge automatically on both sides. If I want, I could put some switch panel right here. I do have my line lock button. I have my switch, which is right over here now. This little switch right there is for the exhaust cutouts. That can go in here. Later on, possibly power windows, power door lock switches,
you know, whatever we want. And we'll have our gauges across there, stereo equipment, equalizer, no cup holders, I don't think. Cup holders used to be here, and they're not, you know, when you're driving, they're not in a, in a reachable area. Back here would certainly be better, but I underneath this is my speedometer box, and there's no real space right there. And inside this box is going to be some speakers here, and there's going to be speakers here on either side. That's the plan. We're going to see if that comes together. That's pretty cool. And, you know, there's going to be a lot of design features in this. It's just not going to be a block of wood or whatever. I'm not even sure what I'm going to make this out of, but, man, I'll tell you what. Those kick panels came out nice. Freaking wire hanging down. I gotta tie that up. Yeah, those kick panels came out so nice and clean and matched the car. Really pleased with that. Nice when you open the, get a nice light on there. Oh, love that. One other thing I think I'm gonna do is I still think I'm gonna move this shifter over slightly so it'll be more over here. I'm not sure what I think I do. I think my arm is, you know, kind of bent to the side where I think I would like it right there would be a little bit more comfortable. I don't know. Working on that. It's all about ergonomics. So this armrest, I want this armrest to be the same height. So I need to measure that to see. I think it needs to come up a little, but that's okay. The size we got, because we can put a cushion on top of this. And we'll see if we've got space to have this open up. That's kind of the goal. But even if I don't, even if this doesn't open up, I had a compartment here before. I never used it. And I wouldn't have all that much space in here. So because there's going to be speakers inside this cabinet. So even if it's not, even if it's just an armrest, I'm fine with that. So now we're getting into the design work. We're going to work out the angles. What this is, this transition, and then we're going to figure out how we can print, 3D print this with the gauges in it, with the hole for the stereo equipment and all of that. So that's what we're going to work on right now. And we're going to see if we can mimic the look of the dashboard. It's got these little tiny lines on it and the bezels for the gauges. We're going to see if we can mimic all that. We'll put a bezel around this equipment and the rest of what's going to be on here, and we'll see if we can print this into this transition. Okay, I think this is the profile I'm going to start with. I'm going to cut out a piece of plywood in this size, and we're going to try and fit it in there and see what it looks like. First cut of the side profile. Need some cleanup, but it's coming along. Wish I had a belt sander. So now we got both sides cut out. Starting to see a nice clean design there. We're still going to taper in the middle right there. Narrow it out. We're coming along. That's looking pretty good. Happy with that. Of course, this is all going to get covered with something to make it look like the rest of the interior. Yeah, that's coming along. Okay, starting to mock things up here. Now, I want to say real quick, if you're a cabinetry guy, you just want to click away. You don't want to watch this. This is going to be cringe worthy. You're going to be in agony and pain watching me try to do this. You're just going to be like, oh God, not, that's not how you hammer a nail. All of it. It's not, yeah. You can't saw that. But yeah. That's how it's going to be. So for everybody else who's never done this before and you're stumbling along just like me, cool. Anyway, I'm working on figuring out ways of getting my widths, and I'm going to have to figure out how to bend this, I think. So, yeah, I've got some wood in between right now to start mocking the widths. Added a couple pieces here that are nailed in with little tiny nails, little cabinet nails. And Yeah, keep in mind this is going to be covered in fabric. I think I'm going to buy the same material. You can buy this material, so I might cover it in that. Do the sides, and then I have something special for the top. That's the plan. Anyway, see if we can cut some more and get some more attached. Okay, so we got these pieces mirrored out. I've got them framed, so I have a decking area to lay the top deck on top of. And now we need to make the separations that are going to clamp this thing together. All cabinet talk, as you can tell. I really know what the hell I'm doing. Okay, coming along. Some adjustments are going to have to be made. It's getting pretty tight up in here, so I think I might trim a little at this end. Just get the front end up a little bit, but it is coming along. I think once the front end comes up, this back end will come down and be a little tighter there, but it is coming along better. Got this end trimmed down a little bit, much tighter along. I'm gonna have to do some work, make some kind of a 3D printed cover for the top of that shifter. It's gonna have to have bulge in it. I'm still thinking about moving the shifter over to this side, closer to one side, but I haven't decided yet.
Well, I think that's going to do it for this video. You can see how far I've gotten. I still got a long way to go. I'm collecting materials and researching for some other ideas. It's kind of an evolving process because I really have no idea what I'm doing, but I have an idea of what I'd like to have. I got parts on order, I got some stuff on the way, so stay tuned for an update. With that said, I want to thank Quadmaster 2, that is the very first person to become a member of this channel. Now, memberships is a feature that you can join and you can get behind the scenes stuff. I'm already sending videos into the membership section, which right now only Quadmaster 2 can see, but this stuff that I do not put on Instagram or for the general public here, that helps support this channel greatly. I thank you very much, Quadmaster 2. He already got something really special that I'll make a video and hone that in for the general population down the line. Some cool little tricks that I'm doing to this thing that I'm not showing anybody else, but you're definitely going to want to see. Probably going to get early releases over into that membership section, but I wanted to say thank you to him for joining up, and maybe you'll consider, link in the description. Anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll be more of this console coming soon, so stick around. Thanks.